team started out this season with singular goals to make it to the NCAA tournament. Nick, that business has been taken care of. Now it's time for the madness to begin in today's game between the New Mexico State Aggies and the Oregon Ducks.
This place is rocking and rolling, baby!
The Ducks should be able to put this team away early, Dick. What's the key to them doing that tonight?
Hey, Brad, for them tonight, the keys are as follows. First of all, the point guard has to be the coach on the floor, making sure his team executes on every possession. Next, make sure you eat up the boards. Finally, play every defensive possession like it's the last.
Well, partner, I say let's get to the action on the court, and we'll see how this one plays out. On the top of the key. And boy, they just jump out of the gate with a score early.
They're sending the message, we're focused, baby.
They've left him completely alone.
He got his jumper off by running that defender into the screen.
Both teams are looking to get something going here. Number one handles the feed. Isolated on the outside, they're working around the arc, looking for the open jumper. For the bucket.
Unbelievable, look at that post position. He can't get a piece of that, baby.
They work it around the perimeter. Entry pass in the paint. Leaning in, trying to draw contact. Dick, I think there's a mismatch in the post.
Can they get him the ball, though?
Inside. Tries for two. Can't get the shot to drop. Had him in the paint, but went elsewhere. Inside. The power forward receives the ball. The kick out. The shooting guard receives the pass. Sinks the shot. He's got to get rid of it. Fake. He takes the shot off the baseline. Off the rim and no good. On the outside. In the paint. Jumps in.
Run him right into the screen again. What did I say? Layup, son. I'm telling you, Brad, you could have a field day against these guys. Why don't you put a uniform on?
Nobody within 10 feet of an easy basket again.
I mean, unbelievable. It's blowout city.
For two, Dick, they're ripping up the nets tonight.
And they're definitely shooting the ball well tonight. Great execution by these boys.
Our three-prong attack tonight, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Brad Nessler with Dick Vitale and our friend EA, Aaron Andrews, checking in from the sideline. Goes up for two, and he scores it off the glass. Trying to pack it inside. He shoots from the baseline. That's good. Fed the low block. Number 32 handles the pass. He stole the ball. Great pressure there.
Fantastic ball pressure. The pressure got to the ball handler, and he lost it.
For the bucket. They really seem to be letting this one get away, Dick.
Yeah, there's been a breakdown somewhere. They need to talk this one over, Brad.
Team that's on the floor is quick, but so's the defense, and they do a nice job. Tries for two.
I did a great job of the ball fake that created the up and under move, and good footwork. It's essential with an up and under move to utilize good footwork.
Entry pass in the paint.
Up and inside.
Dickey's working on that low block on that right hip.
I'll tell you one thing, he's trying to deny him the ball initially, but the defense really doesn't do a great job of sealing him off.
Tough spot defensively in the post, but he got the steal.
Wow, I could have made that steal. He telegraphed that. He was the Marconi guy. What a poor pass.
Number 12 is fired up and ready to go.
I love seeing players play with emotion and passion. There's absolutely nothing wrong with that.
He's not letting the game come to him at all.
Yeah, Brad, he's trying too hard to build a one-man show. He's taking the game away from his other teammates. Come on, man, get with the team, get in the flow.
He attempts the three, way off target. Takes the pass in the paint, drops the bucket despite the harm. On the elbow, they feed down to the low block. Fronts him first, Dick, and then works behind.
Yeah, he's playing from behind him because that tells me right there they don't respect him as an offensive player, and they made an error, obviously, but they don't have the great respect, so they're saying, you know what? Let him get the ball and let him try to beat us.
He goes up strong, and that's going to be an offensive foul.
Oh, great call by the official. He beat him to the spot. That's essential defensively.
Turnaround jumper, and he missed. On the outside. For the bucket, and off the mark. All right, let's check in third member of our team again. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Brad and Dick down here on the sidelines. It looks like the losing team is starting to get a little bit anxious. Their coaches are reminding them just to relax. My observation is it looks like these bright lights have gotten the best of this team so far in the first half.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. Basket falls despite the contact. Rips the ball.
It's not uncommon to have a few high-risers on your team these days. The game has definitely changed in that regard.
Pass down low. There's a drop step, and oh, good defense.
I thought defense reacted and beat him to the spot. Very poor job with the drop step. Very slow.
He'll regroup the offense. They'll work it around the arc. He shoots from the top of the key. He gets that one to fall. Number 32 is charged with the foul. First team foul. He wants to try to get pumped up, Dick. He is feeling it.
Hey, hey, he wants everyone to get up.
He uses the shot fake, and he'll kick it back outside. High post flashes for the ball handler. There's a bad pass right to the defender. Circle. Knocks it down. Dick, this crowd will go silly if they can get some points this trip. Now he faces up on the low block.
I think it's great when you got a post player that can face up on a defensive player and attack the basket.
He takes the shot from the baseline. Off the rim and no good. The Ducks are a stop away from hearing this crowd go senseless. Boy, terrible execution on offense. Takes care of the ball until the offense resets. Here he is defensively, and this is going to be an Academy Award, Dick.
Absolutely, Academy Award at its best.
Now they work it around the perimeter. And there's a lazy pass. It's stolen away. Turnover. Will it turn into two the other way? And the ball goes out of bounds. Gave it up. With a fadeaway jumper. Look at that follow through. Can't get the shot to go. Looking to move it around the perimeter. Tries for two. He gets another shot off and in.
Hey, this show's about to start, Brad.
He keeps the dribble as they reset.
Oh, poor job. Poor job offensively. I'm coaching. He's sitting next to me as an assistant coach. He's pounding the ball to the deck. Where's he going?
Launches the three. Looking for contact, and he scores despite the hack. Looking for a good shot from way outside. Got it. They're going to call this one a backcourt violation, Dick.
You can't make mistakes like that too often, Brad.
Time, the Ducks are up by four. Oregon did a heck of a job shooting that ball in the first half.
I mean, no doubt about it. These boys are given too much time to shoot, if you ask me. They basically have time to wait and get a good shot. The defense was non-existent, Mr. Nessler.
Let's go to the third member of our broadcast team. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Well, Brad and Dick, as you can imagine, both coaches were very intense as I met with them at halftime. They said at this point, it all comes down to playing their game, having fun, and enjoying the moment. Guys?
Thanks, Aaron. He sinks another basket. What are they going to do with this guy, Dick?
I don't know, Brad, but they better do it quickly.
Try to come up with a steal, and they do. For the bucket. Nice shot.
Hey, Brad, it's embarrassing to get scored on like that.
Both teams are looking to get something going here.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
He shoots from left of the circle, makes the shot. Jumped in front to take it away. Shows patience, waiting for the reset.
Look at that spacing.
The power forward with the ball. Goes up for two. He brings it down. Isolated on the outside. They work it around the arc, looking for the open jumper. Top of the circle, they work it around the perimeter.
Inside.
Working it around the perimeter. He puts it up. Way off target. For two. Off the mark. The shooting guard gets the ball. That was nice. Around the perimeter.
Nice fake.
Thinks about the shot. Ball comes back out from the post.
I tell you, Brad, you got to have a post player that anticipates and knows how to find the open man.
Intercepted. Didn't like what he saw on the post and reverses the ball. The skip pass is picked off.
I tell you, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle.
Blocks the shot. Turns it over. He shoots from right of the circle. Off the rim and no good. The defender right on his hip, and I think he's holding his ground, Dick.
Doing a great job. I tell you, doing a phenomenal job not allowing the offensive player to seal the ball.
The Ducks have a mismatch in the post.
Let's see if they can get him the ball.
Fakes a jumper. And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
The Ducks have found a player who cannot seem to miss, Dick.
Daddy's on fire.
Moving it around the perimeter. On the dribble, gives it up. And he'll kick it back outside. He shoots from the top of the circle. He hits it. Dickey's going to kick it back out there from down on the low block.
I tell you, a post player has to be able to read what the defense gives you.
Sinks the shot. Here's the toss back out from the post.
I tell you, coach's dream when your post player can be an exceptional passer.
Makes it. With a fadeaway jumper, look at that follow through. The Ducks have got to continue to get him the ball.
They need to keep feeding him the ball. It's simple.
Him to the punch defensively.
What a terrific job. Footwork really excellent on the post play.
He launches the bomb way off target. Pump fakes. The shooting guard takes the feed. Number 21 is whistled for the foul. First personal foul. What a play! These kids are fired up now. And if you're going to celebrate, why not celebrate with a teammate?
Hey, can you blame them, Brad? They're playing well. He may be in trouble here, Brad.
Steals the pass. Spin move not successful, Dick.
I tell you, great job by the defense not allowing him to make that turn.
Strips the ball. They push it up on the break. Number 12 makes a great move to draw the foul. Let's check in courtside with Aaron Andrews. Aaron?
Well, guys, it's obvious their backs are against the wall. It's going to take a lot of fight and desire to get back into this one. Defensive stops are the words that come to mind, and without them, they just don't have a chance.
Free throws go. Number 32 with the fake. Gave it up. Jumps into the defender. He keeps the concentration off the contact for the score. Got the shot if he wants it. From beyond the arc. He nails the bucket. Fakes it. Dickey's going to kick it back out there from down on the low block.
I tell you, a post player has to be able to read what the defense gives you.
Off the rim and no good. And a momentary look from three-point land. Rims out.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing. Pressure that basketball.
Tries to get the D to bite. Goes up for two.
I tell you, does a great job getting post position. Hey, Brad, that shot's impossible to stop. It's unbelievable. It's not utilized enough.
Number one with the foul. That one puts the personal in personal. Picks up the foul.
I tell you, poor play defensively. Look at the facial expression.
How important is it to get to the free throw line?
Well, you know, those bonus points, Brad, you get those simple points. They add up at the end, plus you get people into foul trouble.
Got them both.
He converts on that free throw line, and that's major.
And he'll kick it back outside. He shoots from the top of the key. Got it. Time to pick up the defense here now. Oh, and you can see the frustration as he picks up the foul.
Oh, that's a bad, bad foul right there, Brad.
The offensive guy now is gaining position down there on the low block, Dick.
I tell you, he gained big-time position by getting the good angle, the good arm entry, and the real extension.
Looking for a good shot. Here's a double team. Off the rim and no good. Spin move's not going to work against a defense like that.
I tell you, they did a great job scouting post play because they were really anticipating the spin.
For two, rims out. Number 33, subpar performance is just destroying his confidence.
He's got to snap out of it. His team needs him. Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. 10 on the shot clock. Picked out of the air. Number 12 picks up the foul. Fourth team foul. Stolen. The point guard gets the pass. For the deuce, easy one.
Look at that spacing.
They move it into the front court. Well, Dick, it looks like they're going to spend a little bit of time fouling right here.
It looks like they're going to slow the game down by fouling, Brad.
Dick, it's obvious to me that they are starting to heat things up right now.
I'll tell you one thing. They're getting good shots, and they're making them count. They're in the groove, baby. And when they're in the groove, that court looks like an unbelievable Atlantic Ocean instead of a teapot.
Foul, and that stops the clock again. Number four comes back into the game.
I tell you, they need their leadership out there. This kid's got leadership skills just like you, Mr. Nestler.
He'll visit the charity stripe. Makes the front end of the 1-1. They're shooting extremely well from the stripe tonight, Dick.
Yeah, they're making their coaches look good for making them shoot extra free throws every day.
Second one is good. They're making good use of their free throw opportunities tonight.
Good free throw shooting teams seem to always give themselves a chance to win.
players got a much-needed breather with that timeout. That brings the lead to 8 points, Dick.
But 8 points doesn't secure a win at this point, Brad.
He shoots from the elbow. The shot's off target. There's a double team waiting there. Number one going to the charity line for the first time tonight. Misses the front end of the 1-1.
He's got hops like you, man. He got hops like you.
Yeah, it is pretty similar.
Wow. I didn't realize my partner was a high rise.
And yet another foul as they're just trying to hang on here.
Nobody likes this part of the game when the losing team is fouling in order to stop the clock.
He goes to the line for the first time. Just like in practice. They're nailing the free ones tonight, Mr. Vitale.
Hey, this is where you win and lose games, Brad.
Missed it. And a big rebound.
Fill the lanes. That's the only way to be able to get some fast break opportunities.
He blocks the shot.
What an unbelievable play, rotating over.
Oh, and you talk about a happy group of fans. Listen to this crowd.
Oh, there's all kinds of people standing and cheering and going wacky.
Cross court. Great defense. For the bucket. He puts it in with contact and all. Well, Dick, sometimes statistics lie, but in this tournament game, I don't think they do. The better team won, and they're going on.
Well, I tell you, they won this game, Brad, when you look at it and analyze it, because they really had all the right people shoot the ball at the right moment. They did a terrific job offensively.
Oregon came, they saw, and they conquered their first-round foe, Dick.
I tell you, Brad, watch out for this team because the coach has these kids playing with more intensity than they ever did during a regular season. And I'm going to tell you, it's going to serve them well as now they shift into gear for that second-round matchup.
Brad Nessler saying so long for my partners Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews. Thanks for joining us.